Y'all see that? I did the porch yesterday, y'all. But we should do these leaves. I'm starting right there. We ain't doing this. Shan will be out. The sun will be out to pick them up. They can see your face because you got the hoodie on. Okay. I'm going to get you that branch. Still hanging. Our pals. It's a big one. You don't want no gloves, Shan? The little blue gloves? So somebody had to hold the bag open while you lift the, put them in the bag.
You can do it. I'm about to do this
now. Done. You get a lot of it up. We had 5 bags or 6 bags. That's hard to do over there because my hostas. I didn't leave that. I'm not carrying them. Uh-huh. You never know who listening. You busted. But I didn't leave it.
Pray this on me. Pray this on me.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Y'all see all my the most, right? We can read the read. I gotta get my stuff. Yeah, 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 yeah. How you doing today? I didn't think I was gonna need my fan, but yeah, y'all already know I always forget something. Okay, so this oh, you say you're not feeling too good. Okay, you said pray for me, Sharon. You know, I'm that girl. I got you. I'm your person. On Grey's Anatomy, Christina was Meredith's person. I'm your person. Father, we come before you today, and we pray for anybody who is not feeling good in their bodies, their mind, their spirit, and their soul. We pray that you heal them. You touch them. You make them whole. You set them free from anything that's keeping them bound in their minds and in their hearts. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. And also, we're keeping those up before you that's mourning because they don't lost loved ones. We pray that you continue to speak to their hearts, strengthen their heart, comfort their hearts. In Jesus' name. I pray, amen, amen, and amen. Got her done, y'all. So the sun is kind of funny. Y'all see it on that side. It's right there, but I can't catch it. So this is it. So y'all, today, y'all want to know what today's date is? Today is November the 8th, Sunday at 12:41 in the p.m. And currently, let me see, it's an update because y'all know. Currently, it feels like 71 degrees. It's really nice outside. It's really nice. It's like that fall nights, not that summer, like 72. Summer 72 could be hot, but it's like a fall 72, so it's pretty decent. So, yeah. So, I showed y'all all those leaves that be out there, right? Them leaves are so big, y'all. Like, for real. Like, some of them be bigger than my face. But we gathered them, me and Ring. We did the areas I showed. Shane came out there and started picking them up. Then George came out there and basically he had the shovel and rake. So he got her done. Until maybe another couple of weeks. We try to tackle it, I think, every 2 weeks is good. Because it'd be a lot. But with all us, when we come together, it don't take that long, you know. Or, I don't know. I think every 2 weeks. But all of them mostly gone. A lot of the trees, the leaves are old. It's just them trees. I'm telling you. Oh, my God. They had to be here from the beginning of time. Like, yeah, but in the back, we ain't touched that back. It's a lot of leaves back there, but we don't leave that for the hubby. Forget that. That's too much. The front good, you know, people be walking, you know, mail lady be coming through, and the UPS, you know, kind of like clear a path, clear a path for them. And for myself, because I don't like all of that rain and the hubby, like, it look cute, it look nice. Yeah. But after a while. So, that's that. This is my thing I had on with my dress when I went out there to rake the leaves. So, we finna get myself looking halfway decent on here. Let me just put that in like a scoochie. So, I brought everything to the table, y'all. I don't know what I'm gonna do. But y'all finna see me transform, right? Huh? Let's do this. Let's take this down. So it's real nice. I need to go to Kohl's. I got a package yesterday. And I need to return some stuff that I got. It was itching. So let's see what we're gonna do. I ordered me another compact mirror. Which y'all proud of me. Cause I got her done. Okay, that part's still good. I be sweating, y'all. I am a sweater. So yeah, I should have brought my garbage can. That's my hair. Shit, it's not that bad, but enough. So, I'm gonna get them edges. And my hair thin. Shan, come bring my waste basket, please. So I could, like, throw this, get rid of this hair. This side? Just sit right there. Thank you. What you doing, baby Shane? What you playing? You playing your game? Yeah. What game you playing? COD? Yeah. That's your favorite game? Yeah. Oh, wow. Y'all finna see me have a whole going to a frenzy about this hair. How's y'all? Ooh, can't stand here. Like, everywhere. So yeah. Let's see. Let's try something different. How about that? Let's try some. Oh Lord, this mirror is so small. Let's try something a little different. I don't know. Let's see.
Yeah. Convict music. See, I can kind of recall a little ways back. Small trying to ball, always been black. And my hair, I tried it all. I even went flat, had a gummy curly top and all that crap. Now, just trying to be appreciated. Nappy headed brothers never had no ladies. Then I hit the barbershop real quick, had them give me little twists, and it drove them crazy. I couldn't get no job. Corporate wouldn't hire no dreadlocks. Ooh, then I thought about my dogs on the block. Kinda understand why they chose to steal and rob. Was it the hair that got me this far? All these girls, these cribs, these cars. I hate to say it, but it seems so flawed. Cause success didn't come till I cut it all off.
Little girl with the pressing curl. Age 8, I got a jerry curl. 13 and I got a relaxer. I was a source of so much laughter. At 15 when it all broke off. 18 when I went all natural. February 2002 I went on and did what I had to do. Because it was time to change my life. To become the woman that I am inside. 97 dreadlocks all gone. Like a slave at the turn of the century. It's time for us to redefine who we be. You can shave it off like a South African beauty. Got it on lock like Bob Marley. You can rock it straight like Oprah Winfrey. If it's not what's on your head, it's what's underneath. And say hey, I am not my head. I am not your skin. I am not your expectations. No,
with the wave cap and the cops wanna harass cause I got babes. Ain't seen nothing like that in all my days. Man, you gotta change all this fearing. Steady judging one another by their appearance. Yes, India, I feel you, girl. Now go ahead, talk to the rest of the world. Cause
the way I wear my hair make me a better person. Cause the way I wear my hair make me a better friend. Oh, there's a way I wear my head, you talk about my integrity. And expressing my creativity. Breast cancer, chemotherapy. Took away her crown of glory.
Okay.
She promised God she was to survive. She will enjoy every day of her life. On national television, her diamond eyes are sparkling. Bob headed like a full moon shining. Singing out to the whole wide world like, hey, 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 hey.
Too crazy.
It's a new life for me. Yeah.
Do something a little different. I could have just tucked this under.
New life for me. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea. You know how I feel. River running free,
Okay. You know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean. Okay, I'm ready. So, y'all ready for this read now? Since I done transformed before y'all. I don't know if I want this. So, here we go. Smoking and health. Glasses check. It's gonna be a hard time putting them on with that right there. Oops. Still there. They blurry, but not today. So, mid to late 1970s. Nice little lengthy read. Here we go. Topic. Light does not actually mean less. Quote, Marlboro Light cigarettes were not smoked like regular Marlboros. In effect, the Marlboro 85 smokers in the study did not achieve any reduction in smoke intake by smoking a cigarette called Marlboro Lights. And that was quoted by Philip Morris back in 1975. Wow. Okay, next topic. And lower nicotine levels might wean smokers off the habit. Quote, there is a danger in the current trend of lower and lower cigarette deliveries. Example, the smoker will be weaned away from the habit if the nicotine delivery is reduced below a threshold satisfactory level, then surely smokers will question more readily while they are indulging in an expensive habit. Because it do become expensive when you're addicted. Man, imagine. I don't even know how much a pack of cigarettes costs today, but oh my goodness. And that was quoted by Bat back in 1977. So if they lower and lowering nicotine levels might wean smokers off the habit. The smoker will be weaned away from the habit if the nicotine delivery is reduced below a threshold satisfactory level, then surely smokers will question more readily why they are indulging in an expensive habit. See, it's, and that's kind of like weird because it's saying like if they reduce the nicotine level, that's when the smoker will start to question, why am I spending this much on these pack of cigarettes? But until then, they don't question it because the addiction has taken over. You know, they being controlled by the addiction, but when they start being weaned away, they can start thinking. So basically it's saying when you're addicted to things, the addiction is controlling your thought process. But when you start weaned away, you start being able to use your own brain and question things. Wow. Well, okay. Here we go. Next topic. And lower nicotine level. We will just manipulate the pH. Wow, manipulate. And that's the word they're using, manipulate. Okay, quote, as the pH increases, the nicotine changes its chemical form. It's still a chemical, nevertheless, it just changes form so that it is more rapidly absorbed by the body and more quickly, wow, gives a kick to the smoker. And that was quoted by Jay McKenzie back in 1976. These people crazy. This is on this crazy is like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde crazy when they was who was that creating Frankenstein type of crazy? Wow. Manipulate the pH. The nicotine changes its chemical form so that it is more rapidly absorbed by the body and more quickly gives a kick to the smoker. They're gonna get it all in quick. But that's how it is when you got a when you got a habit. You know, you could start off with cigarette habit, but then, you know, the longer you have that habit, sometimes the stronger you want the thing, you know, because you want to get that hit, that fix quick. Wow. Man, imagine that heroin and the liquid form going straight into your blood, like your in your veins and all in your system and everything. And that's like, that's powerful because it's in a liquid form too. Oh my goodness. And that's how people just OD just like that. That stuff, I mean, how do they make make heroin? Like the liquid drug that people just OD from like that. Like, who does that, people? Who does that, okay? Let's keep it moving. Stay focused, Sharon. Topic, and just carry on reassuring the customers. Topic, info, a marketing paper for BAT states, quote, all work in this area should be directed towards providing consumer reassurance about cigarettes and the smoking habit, a habit, an addiction. This can be provided in different ways. Example, by claiming low deliveries, by the perception of low deliveries, and by the perception of mildness. All deception, all manipulation, all evil. Okay, and that was quoted by P. Short back in 1977. Man, this stuff will get your blood to boiling for real, for real. Wow. And whoa. Okay, topic. However, filters are just a con. Man, this is the truth is coming out. And info, Brown and Williamson's lawyer, quote, in most cases, however, the smoker of a filter cigarette was getting as much or more nicotine and tar as he would have gotten from a regular cigarette. He had abandoned the regular cigarette, however, on the grounds of reduced risk of to health. And that was quoted by E. Peoples back in 1976. This was a Brown and Williamson lawyer quoted this, saying he getting the smoker of a filter cigarette was getting as much or more nicotine and tar. I still can't get over the word, get over that tar is even in it have anything to do with a cigarette, y'all, and ammonia. Like what? As he would have gotten from a regular cigarette. Deception, deception, deception. And so he had abandoned the regular cigarette, however, on the grounds thinking that it's safer. It's not that bad. But you're getting more nicotine and tar in your body. Oh my God. I feel like something itchy. Something making me itch. Okay. Here we go. Topic. And we are conning people about Lothar. Wow. I really wonder who wrote this paper. It's anonymous. Info. One tobacco scientist concludes. Quote. The effect of switching to Lothar cigarette may be to increase, not decrease, the risk of smoking. Wow. And whoa. And that was quoted by P. Lee for BAT, B-A-T, back in 1979. Topic. And is it really ethical anyway? Info. A scientist at Liggett asked, quote, is it morally permissible to develop a safe method for administering a habit-forming drug when, in so doing, the number of addicts will increase? Wow. And that was quoted by Liggett, a scientist at Liggett, back in 1978. Let's read that again. Is it morally? And see, that's the key word to morals. Because 2020, well, this was way back in the 70s, but whoa! These people like morals. They like care. They like concern. All they thinking about is the almighty dollar. All about the Benjamin. Money over people. Is it morally permissible to develop a safe method for administering a habit-forming drug? Habit-forming drug when, in so doing, the number of addicts will increase. This is so sick. My heart goes out to all the smokers that's smoking and taking these chemicals into their bodies. All the ones before that smoke and done passed due to smoking, the carcinogens, the nicotine, the tar, the ammonia, and eventually, you know, lung cancer and all that type of stuff that done passed. Man, whoa. What's that word? Can you get, what's that word? Y'all know that word, reparations or something, when you're trying to get money from, like how the slaves wanted money from how they was treated or something like that. What's the word they be wanting? Y'all don't know, y'all ain't heard of that word? Reparations? Can the families get that done lost loved ones due to lung cancer from smoking and the carcinogens and all of that? I mean, it should be something that could come into play when you can file something, because they straight up killing these people. Ain't no different than what's going on in the world today. You know, people have to be held accountable on all levels. So I got her done, y'all. That was good. It's winding down, y'all. Y'all see how much I got to go? I ain't got that much to go. So we getting down to the nitty gritty. Today is, y'all know how my memory set up. Ooh, y'all, my anniversary coming up. It's my anniversary. November the 8th, Sunday. Next. My anniversary is on the 10th. So that'll be Tuesday. And me and the hubby will be married 28 years. Whoa. Woo! That sounds like a long time, y'all. Yeah, wow, that is a long time. Oh, for real. What happened to my other paper? So it's so winding down. I'm here to show y'all how much I don't read. I don't read. This is the beginning. I started July 2nd. July, August, September, October, November. I've been reading this paper 5 months. Don't even seem like it's been that long. Like my marriage. 28 years. Don't even seem like it's been that long. But this all I don't read. Like, it's a lot of pages. Like a lot. Running back at that. Running back. So, I just got this much to go. Not much at all. We almost done. So my paper clip. So I hope y'all enjoyed that read. And again. When I read these reads, this, my input and my insight is mad. This is where the read take me, my thought process. And the things that my brain, like my thoughts that my brain form and the words that come out of my mouth come from my heart. You know what I'm saying? Because it's ridiculous. I mean, though it's really not a word that could really describe how I really feel about this whole read. You get what I'm saying? I love the read, but just the information. It's like, really? And whoa. The mind of man. The mind of people. The thoughts. The imagination. Whoa. So, y'all, I hope y'all enjoyed that read. I hope y'all enjoyed my insight, my input, and everything. So, today is Sunday. This is going to be my Wednesday read. So, I hope everybody have a blessed Wednesday, a safe Wednesday, a productive Wednesday, get her done, and protect the Wednesday and Thursday. And I see y'all back at the table on Friday. The week's going by so fast. These months are going by so fast. We're going to be in 2021, like, just like that. And on that note, I'm out. Peace, love, share some, and what a holla. Bye, y'all. Did I have to say y'all protective? Right, Wednesday, Thursday. Yeah, I feel like I said that. All right, bye, y'all.